operations forces evacuated government personnel from the American embassy in Khartoum. Now, governments around the world are struggling.
Hey guys, welcome back.
Capital Khartoum this morning is
another video.
And at the airport, which remains closed, there's no power or running water. Phone and internet service are largely down.
So
it's a nightmare scenario as nations around the world struggle to evacuate personnel. France, Italy, Germany, Spain,
today,
and others carrying out successful flights to bring out their citizens and some Americans. This weekend, the United States launched a rescue mission to the U.S. Embassy in Khartoum, which is now closed. U.S. Special Operations flying 800 miles from Djibouti
so
to Sudan,
I got try something
on the embassy grounds,
different.
Where three Chinook helicopters evacuated 80 government personnel and their families.
So
in around an hour, there were no reports of injuries or incidents, but there are still roughly 16,000 American citizens
I got
in Sudan,
ready.
Many dual nationals. They're sheltering
so,
in place.
Yeah.
For now, there are no plans
I got,
for mass rescue. Lakshmi Parthasarathy, an American travel writer, was visiting Sudan and is stuck. She managed to send us this video
and,
this morning.
The city is so tense right
the
now.
Sweatshirt.
A lot of people are fleeing left and right.
Yeah.
And you can see the cars.
And,
I'm actually making arrangements to try and get out as well to an area outside of the city that is safer.
This morning
no power,
is good. I will be on time. And
so I'm preparing to go it alone and see where I can get myself
so
to safety.
I'm supposed to go to
two of Sudan's top generals who took over
on
a
the bus
and promised to transition to civilian rule
yeah.
are now battling among themselves for control of the
country.
Rich
don't try this at
all. There's a risk of state collapse and a return to civil war.
Richard, it seems to grow more grim by the hour. There are Americans who are there. We just saw one. What is the U.S. government doing to help them?
Yeah.
Well, I think the government has made it clear that the
my
board
is coming back.
Effort, at least not at the moment.
Today,
the government and the opposition forces that are fighting these two
generals. So my parents is going to
so as you heard in the
doctors
Americans who are still there when they call the embassy most
and
recording telling them to shelter in place so they are taking matters into their own hands trying to get out of the capital
yeah.
trying to get to the borders any way they
the
can
the doctor's
right,
appointment
thank you very much.
My parents
meantime,
is going
the 2024
to
presidential race
and
is heating up with President Biden expected to launch his re-election campaign within
so
days.
I'm going
to try
a different
not
video
about
like
rematch
productive
the president and Donald Trump. NBC's chief White House correspondent Peter Alexander has more on these numbers. Hey Peter, good morning.
Oh, I didn't show you guys my lunch pill. So it's after 7.
Bid, our new NBC News poll nearly half of those who say President Biden should not run cite his age as a major reason why. At 80, he's already the oldest president ever to serve. Still, allies are downplaying concerns about the president's age.
He is an active president who is meeting the challenges of America every day.
But he's not the only one facing headwinds. 6 in 10 Americans, including a third of Republicans, President Donald Trump should not run again either. But his recent indictment in New York and other looming criminal investigations have only strengthened his position among Republicans.
Yeah.
Now 68% say they back him to be their nominee. Support for one of Mr. Trump's
and that's what he does. So, when I come back, I will do some just a little bit from work and yeah, focusing on YouTube and just some.
That's good.
Okay.
Make sure you have your key because you might come home. We're not home yet because me and mommy are going to hospital.
Oh my Lord. That's a backyard. We are going, Mingos. Yeah, we are going. We are going, Mingos. And I did show you guys.
Angela, you got it.
Oh my God.
This report is sponsored by Macy's. Third Street Tunnel tied up with a northbound collision became massive pieces out of.
Guys, my dad was begging the cycle bin. Yeah, that's. I don't know why, guys. So. I'm in a car. My dad is gonna drop me off because my dad cannot be. Yeah. I just told you guys what dad said. And I did show you guys the, we are going Mingos and like yeah the plant is growing. I did show you guys what my mom did and yeah my faith is so, yeah, it's clearing, and yeah, I don't know why I'm so excited for this week and get the check. Oh my God.
Network, only from Xfinity. The future starts now. Restrictions apply, not available in all areas. Actual speeds vary, not guaranteed.
Yeah. Next time on Tuesday, I'll go for their child. In a bus.
So many possibilities. The Maryland 529 Save for College State Contribution Program can help keep your future within reach, whether they choose
tomorrow,
college, an apprenticeship, or trade school.
Let's see
Maryland529.com.
What happened?
Read the investment plan disclosure statement, which includes investments, costs, fees, and other information you should consider carefully before investing. Non-Maryland residents should check with their state's 529 plan for tax and other state benefits.
I'm Antoine Davis. I'm a radio personality, and I do my thing my way. That's called style. And for my beer style, I cleanse with the King Sea Delight beer and face wash.
It's infused with coconut water, happy avocado oil, Monday. Oh, I just say over there, but that's better.
Don't forget, master your style with King C. Gillette.
Pack your bags. The
is it over there? Huh? I can feel it over there.
Lodging, motor coach transportation, and more. Sign up at ftgtours.com or call or text 240-244-9330.
I just want to say, I'm gonna end the video. Give me a big like, subscribe my channel, and stuff. Oh, I need to like focusing at school. Yeah, that's the point. Guys, more video.